Hi student, welcome to botany class. Today we are going to see the paleobotany. So what is the paleobotany? The study of the past life form of the plants. You hear the Jurassic is one kind of animal is lived a millions of years ago. How can we know the Jurassic animal is lived in the earth? So we get some of the skeletal structure or some of the fragmented plant parts from a different part of the world, so we can realize that this plant or this kind of the animal is lived in previous year or millions of years ago. But due to the evolution or climatic change, this animal is totally eradicated from the world. Like that, if some of the climatic changes will be happen, as a result, some form of the plant group, it will be eradicated from the world. But some segment of the particular plant, it will be present in the earth crust. So it may be the leaf, or it may be the stem, or it may be the root. Never we get the entire plant, we can get the segment of the particular plant due to the earth crust. Okay, so due to some pressure will be created on the particular plant, as a result, the impression of the particular plant, it will be present in the soil. So the study of the past form of the life of the plants, that is called paleobotany. So paleo means past. We are going to see that the paleobotany in India, the term farm genera. So we can use the term farm genera. So farm genera means the fossil plant or the past plant is never get the entire. We can get from the soil in the form of the segments. In the form of the segment. It may be the leaf segment or it may be a stem segment like that. Not the entire leaf we get, even some part of the leaf segment. So the segmented part is generally called form genera. Okay, so the term farm genera is used to name the fossil plants. Because the whole plant is not recovered as the fossil. So in the fossil form, we don't get the whole plant. Instead of that, we can get either the organ of the particular plant or the parts of the extinct the plants or obtained in a fragment. So here you can see that it's a leaf segment. So this is also the leaf segment. It's a wood segment. Okay, we never get the entire plant. Instead of that, we can get a different fragment of the plant body. So that is called form genera. You can know this term. The form genera is helped to naming the fossil plant. It may be leaf, maybe a stem or it will be like that. We never get the entire plant. We get the segment of the particular plants. So some of the fossil rich site in India. So we have only discussed about the paleobotany studies in India. So some of the fossil rich site in India, that is the Shivalik Fossil Park. It located in Himachala Pradesh. It's full and full. It will be have the museum, that means the preserved form of the number of animal, especially for the vertebrate animal segments are collected in this fossil park. And then the Mandala Fossil Park, Madhya Pradesh. So here it's only preserved or only collected the plant parts. So only the past plant are collected in this part. And Rajmahal Hills, Jharkhand. So here also is only collected the plant part. And Arayalum in Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu, Arayalum is a fossil rich site in India. So different fossil rich site in India, that is Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand and Tamil Nadu. In Himachal Pradesh, Shivalik fossil park. In Madhya Pradesh, Mandala fossil park. In Jharkhand, Rajmahal Hills. And in Tamil Nadu, Arayalum. Some of the fossil representative of a different plant group given here, that is the fossil form of the algae, fossil form of the bryophyte, fossil form of the gymnosperm, fossil form of teratophyte, and fossil form of angiosperm also given here. The fossil form of algae, bryophyte, teratophyte, gymnosperm and angiosperm. So what are the fossil form we can collect or we can preserve? Now we are going to see the fossil algae. The first one is Paleoporella. So this is a Paleoporella. It belongs to green algae. So it is a fossil form. Not the real form, it's a fossil form. And Dimorphocyphon. This is a Dimorphocyphon fossil record. In bryophyte, Nyadita, it's a one of the fossil form. Nyadita, this is a Nyadita fossil form. And the hepaticities, this is a hepaticities. And mycetes, it's a mycetes fossil form. In bryophyte, there are three fossil forms are recorded, that is Nyadita, hepaticities, and mycetes. In teratophyte, so there are four fossil records there, that is Tuxonia, Rhynia, Barmentia and Calamitis. So that is a Tuxonia, that is a Rhynia, it is a Barmentia, there is a leaf, it represents the leaf and it is a Calamitis. And in gymnosperm, Medullosa fossil form. Lepidocarpon, Williamsonia, Lepidodendron. So there is a Medullosa, it is a Lepidocarpon, it is a Williamsonia, it is a Lepidodendron in gymnosperm. The four form of the fossil are recorded. In angiosperm also, that is Aracanthus and Furcula. Aracanthus and Furcula, these two angiosperm fossil record are available. So that is Aracanthus, is a Furcula. Okay. So these are some of the fossil form. Now we are going to see the father of Indian paleobotany. That is Professor Birbal Saini in 1891 to 1949. So he is a Professor Birbal Saini. He made a lot of studies, lot of contribution to the paleobotany. So for that, in India, we can honor the particular scientist for our India government to launch the paleobotany studies. So for that, the institute is named as a Birbal Saini Institute of Paleobotany. It is located in Lucknow. Because of several contribution of this scientist, Birbal Saini, to especially for paleobotany. He made a studies on Rajmahal Hills. So the Professor Birbal Saini is a father of Indian paleobotany. He described the fossil plant from Rajmahal Hills of eastern Bihar. Pentacylon Saini, Nepani Cylon, are some of the form genera described by Birbal Saini. So due to that, their several contribution, not only that, a several contribution to the paleobotany studies in India. So our government to honor the particular scientist to make a new institute for named as the particular scientist, that is Birbal Saini Institute of Paleobotany, is located in Lucknow. Thank you, Sudha. That's all about the paleobotany.